disability and gender diverse people still face. And with that visibility, you would hope comes understanding. But understanding which is clearly still not present in some quarters of this university. I also want to acknowledge, however, that visibility comes with a price. And it's often that it's the visibility that can put trans people at risk from those that seek to do you harm. And for some in the community, in particular trans people of colour, that visibility, and in fact that turns into hyper-visibility, can lead to more discrimination and violence. And which is a really, really heavy burden to bear. And it's important to acknowledge these hardships and appreciate the sheer strength and resilience that it takes to simply exist in this world as a trans or gender diverse person. And I think you are all amazing, absolutely amazing. So many of you have struggled so hard to get to where you are today. And so many, alongside your own personal struggles, are absolutely committed and working for the rights of other people, working for the rights, the health and the well-being of the trans and gender diverse community. And the work that you do is so important because trans rights are human rights. Woo!
Shout out
out to the bloke that I sat next to at dinner on Monday night, who looked absolutely awesome in his suit. And it wasn't until I got home and was sort of reading my Twitter stream that I found out that it was the first time he actually worn a suit out to dinner since he had been transitioned as a man. I want to shout out to the two co-conveners of the Greens in Victoria, Effie Eldon and Nissa Sims, who are doing amazing work. They're working hard every day to be fighting for the shared values and to be pushing for the much needed change that we need to see in our country. I want a big shout out to all the young people in particular and all of you here who are so proud and in expressing and in being out and open with your gender identity, expressing your gender identity, being who you are, whether you're trans, whether you're a non-binary, gender fluid, and a big shout out to my friend Michelle McNamara, who is here. There she is. Okay, who has given her all trying to make this university to realise and take them to task and to get them to see that their acceptance of the transphobia that masquerades as academic freedom helps make this campus bloody unsafe for many trans and gender diverse people who don't feel supported by their university, and that is tragic. And it needs to change. And that's why this event today is so important, and particularly on Trans Day of Visibility. So I want to finish by expressing my wholehearted support for the aim of this rally. I'll let you know, Holly Lawford-Smith actually emailed me yesterday asking me to not appear at this rally because I would give it legitimacy. And I politely emailed her back and said, yep, I'm appearing. And we would just have to disagree in our views. So I want to wholeheartedly support the AIM-VIRS rally, to call on the university to stop promoting transphobia, to condemn the No Conflict They Say website, and to stop hiding behind academic freedom to justify transphobia. Free speech does not extend to hate speech. Thank you for inviting me to be here with you today, and I look forward to keep on working with you until we win, until this journey towards equality is over, until we have reached equality, and that we actually reach our destination where everyone of all sexes, all sexual orientations, all gender identities are celebrated and supported in the ways that we all deserve. Thank you.